नमस्कार। पार्किंसन डिजीज इज वन ऑफ अ प्रोग्रेसिव नर्वस सिस्टम डिसऑर्डर। हियर इन बॉडी शेकी मूवमेंट स्टार्ट, ट्रेमर स्टार्ट, वॉलंटरी मूवमेंट्स आर रिड्यूस्ड, इन वॉलंटरी मूवमेंट स्टार्ट इन बॉडी, पर्सन सर्टन एरियाज बिकम वेरी टाइट एंड स्टिफ, देयर इज लॉट्स ऑफ टेंशन इन मसल्स, मूवमेंट्स आर डिस्टर्ब्ड, एम्पर्ड, writing skill is totally disturbed. Many such things happen in Parkinson's disease. So how to manage this condition? Yoga deals with nervous system a lot. Yoga deals with nerves, mind and its management. And yoga can become a very strong support with the treatment of Parkinson's disease. Medically, certain things have to be done for Parkinson's. But if you join yoga along with it, that would really help patient to come out of all these symptoms which really bothers everybody. So here are some yoga techniques to manage these symptoms. Number one, heightened awareness about your body and its movements. You must know what angle the body is shaking. Certain angles body shakes, in certain angles it doesn't shake. So for example, if I'm holding my hand like this and if it is shaking, I should just change the angle of a position and it will not shake. I'm standing in one position, it will shake, in another position it will not. So slowly a person has to register the areas where shakiness is more. So when person registers shakiness, person has to change the angle, person has to take some support to see that shakiness is not there. If shakiness continues, then the cells of our body will receive that message and those cells will make body shake more, because that's a memory with cells. So try and see that you avoid maximum shakiness and change yourself, adapt to a new situation, adapt to a new habits, and help yourself out. It is observed that facial muscles get tightened, stiffness, the lower jaw becomes stiff, you can't move, you can't talk so easily, facial muscles are very tight. So certain facial exercises would work wonders. Try and see that you fill water in your mouth, make your mouth bloated, stay in that position for some time and then drink the water. This habit person should form to see that the facial muscles are exercised. Similarly, keeping your mouth wide open and doing what is called as lion pose. Protrude your tongue out as much as possible. Open your mouth absolutely widely. Make your eyes also wide and stay in that position for some time. This is a very good facial exercise. Third, try and see that you move your tongues here and there. Your tongue on the left side, pull it out. Then on the right side, pull it out. Rotate it in your mouth and see that you count your teeth every day from up to down. So this is how movement of your tongue also is very, very important when person is suffering from Parkinson. Another exercise which will release the stress from the facial muscle would be eye exercise, Tratak. Rotating your eyes right to left, left to right, looking at the shoulder, looking at the tip of the nose, at the center of the eyebrows, tightening your eyes, relaxing, tightening your muscles and relaxing, widening it and relaxing. All such little movements of eyes would help to see that the area doesn't get tight and it remains relaxed. Third, we should do something to bring balance and focus, and for that, certain asanas are very essential. First, one asana which is very important is Talasana. Yogendra Talasana, number one and number two. Here, person is definitely holding something like a table or a rod, raising the arm up, stretching your body completely upwards, raising on the toe, and then coming back, rotating your arm and doing the same with other hand. But remember one thing very well: any movement you do with your hands, you should involve breathing rhythm along with it. So here you will be breathing fully, like you are, you will be inhaling to raise your arms up, holding for 2 to 4 seconds, and then breathing out, you will come back. So this breathing along with muscular movement really give you double benefit. With breathing rhythm, your body becomes much better and much stronger. Second asana would be Ek Padasana, standing on one leg. Standing firmly, hold something so that you don't fall. Bring your one foot over the other thigh and stay in that position for some time, that balancing, standing for some time. Holding your muscles without shaking is a beautiful technique. Fourth, you must do certain asanas to release the stiffness from your body. Body has to exercise in various directions. Especially yogis say your vertebral column, your spine, should be flexible in all different directions. And so, you should do asanas to see that you are doing some asana for forward bend, for backward bend, for sideward bend, for twist, for upward push, and for head low. So these are the ways in which you should be moving your body, but with breathing rhythm. Breathe in and move, breathe out and come back. Involve respiratory system, breathing rhythm with body movement, and that would work wonders. So here are a few asanas to exercise spine in all the directions. Number one, to give upward stretch to your spine, do Parvatasana. In Parvatasana, sit on chair or on the floor in any meditative pose and move your arms from side upwards, stretch your body upwards and bring it down, but with breathing rhythm. Inhale, move your hands up, exhale, bring it down. Number two, to give forward bending to your spine, do Hastapadasana. So stand straight, legs little apart, breathe in, bend back, breathe out, bend forward completely. Try and relax in that position for some time. Stay empty for some time. And while breathing in, come back again fully. And breathe out, come back to normal position. This should be done 2-3 times in a day. Third, to give backward bend to your spine, do Bhujangasana. Lie down on your abdomen and bring your both arms on the side and lift your head up. Or you can hold your both arms behind and with the support of arms stretched backward, lift your head up and come back to normal position. When you are lifting upwards, you are inhaling fully and coming back, you are breathing out. Fourth asana, side bend to the spine, and so we do Konasana. Konasana number two. So stand straight, legs apart. Inhale, take your arm from side, go to the other side, bend as much as you can sideways, and then while coming back, you exhale and come back. And do it on both the sides. So it is a sideward bend. Fifth, to give twist to your spine. Here is an asana called as Vakrasana. Stand straight, legs apart, stretch your arms straight and then go twisting to the sideways. Twist as much as you can while breathing out and come back while breathing in. Do that on the other side and do this asana systematically. Even sitting with legs stretched, you can do the twisting on the right side as well as on the left side. So try and do twisting also regularly. And the last asana would be inversion posture, and so that is Sarvangasana. So lie down on your back, slowly lift your legs up and then lift your bottom up and hold your waist with your both arms nicely and try and stretch yourself upwards as much as you can. Stay in that position for some time. This is a static variation, and do your pranayama number 4 in that position. Your breathing continues. Breathe in, stomach up, breathe out, stomach down. Staying in that position for some time. Remain for half a minute and then come back normally. Fifth point, do some rhythm awareness practices. These rhythm awareness would really help in strengthening your nervous system. So do practices like Anulom Vilom Pranayama, Here you are taking a rhythmic breathing. Inhale from one side, hold little bit, exhale from another side. Again, do the same on the opposite side. You go on doing this. This rhythm has to be maintained, and that helps in strengthening your nerves. Do nispanda bhav, that is listening to the sound passively. Preferably pick up some rhythmic sound, like a clock, tick-tock, tick-tock of a clock. Or if a fan is making a sound, then that also goes into a rhythm. Find out some rhythmic sound, or there are some rhythmic sound available also in your mobile phone. Pick up some and try and listen to that sound peacefully for 5 to 10 minutes. Third, pranayam number 4. In pranayam 4, lie down on your back, fold both the legs closer to you, keep one arm on your stomach and start rhythmic breathing. That is, breathe in, your abdomen goes up, breathe out, abdomen goes down. Go on doing this rhythmic breathing for again 5 minutes. That would work wonders. Sixth point, in Parkinson, it is observed that shoulders get slouched. The curve comes on the shoulder. The posture becomes very poor. And so, this slouching and stiffness of the shoulder has to be removed. Here are some asanas, basically all hand and neck exercises that would work wonders. Different movements of your arms would really help to see that your posture remains straight, the spine is straight, so that your breathing, your digestion, everything becomes correct. So some asanas you should do it regularly. I think so everybody should do regularly. First, you should interlock your fingers behind and bring your arm up and down. This will really give a good movement to your shoulder. Lie down on your stomach and do the same. Lift your arms up and down. And do the variation of Bhujangasana. When you are lifting your head up but not touching to the floor, and that would work wonders. Second would be Dhanurvakrasana. You are holding your both arms with the ankles and then lifting your whole body up. So it's a back curve, and this would keep your shoulders intact, straight, and slouching would be gone. So understand, for Parkinson's disease, yoga is the great complementary therapy along with medical therapy. So try and see that all these things what we have shown you, person starts doing it, person starts taking charge of himself, person starts becoming aware of each movement what he is doing, so that he doesn't do mistakes of falling down or shaking more. So when this joins with the medical support, person can really manage Parkinson's disease very well in life, and it would not become so progressive. It would remain as it is, and that's how the life would be definitely better and beautiful. Namaskar.